Called to walk in the way of the man who stilled the waters. Called to walk in the way of the man who calmed the sea. Called to live in the world and be free to live for others. Called to walk in the way of the man from Galilee.
Thanksgiving Masses offered by Mr. P. V. Jose and Annie for the intentions of William Verghese, Violet Jack for good health, and Joseph Peter D'Souza for a speedy recovery. Month's Mind Mass of Stephanie Andrade, first death anniversary of Anthony Silva Pinto, death anniversaries of Scott Roy D'Souza and Joseph Kunju Kunju. For the souls of Mariam Alukaran, Sheila, Tony and Nikhil Brito, Joe Dias, Peter D'Souza, Sarah Augustine, Lloyd D'Souza, Rufina and Jose Letao, Anthony, Rosie and George D'Souza, John and Flory Correa, and departed members of family, Francisco and Maria Montserrat, Magdalene Patrao, and departed members of family, Nicholas Picardo, Cecilia, Peter, and Seraphin Castellino, Manuel Mendoza, Luis D'Souza, Fathers Anthony Cardozo, Peter D'Souza, and Ozzy D'Souza, Cajetan Fernandez, Austin, Pauline, Irene, and Ruby Rotten, Maria D'Souza, Francis Thomas Pinto, and departed members of family, and Patricia Nagpal and Dorothy Schofield. For the departed members of Fernandez, Pereira, Remedios, and Disa families, and for the souls in purgatory.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you.
And with your spirit.
My sisters and brothers, today the Church celebrates the sainthood of two of the apostles, Jude and Simon. Simon the Zealot, who was zealous about the Jewish law and the Canaanite law, and Jude, not Judas Iscariot, but Jude, Judas, the brother of James, a relative of Jesus as well. Nothing in certainty is mentioned about their life in the scriptures, but tradition has it that they both went to Persia, and it is there that they were martyred. Even though nothing is mentioned about these two great apostles, this feast reminds us, though we are not appreciated for our work, God sees our work and He rewards it. We are all called to continue the work of the apostles because our faith is based on their faith, their witnesses. But for the times we have failed to commit ourselves like the apostles, we ask the Lord pardon and forgiveness. Have mercy on us, O Lord.
Have mercy on us.
For we have sinned against you. Show us, O Lord, your mercy and grant us your salvation. And may Almighty God have mercy upon us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Let us join in singing the Gloria.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Glory to you, Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away our sin. Have mercy on us and receive our prayer. You alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. We pray for our own intentions. We pray for God's blessings on those who are celebrating their birthdays and anniversaries. We pray for all those who are sick, recovering, that the Lord may heal them. I request you to pray for me, that I may be responsible in my calling and be faithful to the Lord. O God, who by the blessed apostles have brought us to acknowledge your name, graciously grant, through the intercession of Saints Simon and Jude, that the Church may constantly grow by increase of the peoples who believe in you, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The first reading, a reading from the letter of Saint Paul to the Ephesians. Brethren, you are no longer strangers and aliens, but you are fellow citizens with the saints and members of the household of God, built on the foundation of the apostles and prophets, Christ Jesus himself being the cornerstone, in whom the whole structure, being joined together, grows into a holy temple in the Lord. In him, you also are being put together into a dwelling place for God by the Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response: their sound goes forth through all the earth.
Their sound goes forth through all the earth.
The heavens declare the glory of God, and the firmament proclaims the work of his hands. Day unto day conveys the message, and night unto night imparts the knowledge.
Their sound goes forth through all the earth.
No speech, no word, whose voice goes unheeded. Their sound goes forth through all the earth, their message to the utmost bounds of the world.
Their sound goes forth through all the earth. Let us now prepare our hearts to hear the word of God. Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia.
We praise you, O God. We acclaim you as Lord. The glorious company of the apostles praise you.
Alleluia, alleluia. Spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
In those days Jesus went out to the mountain to pray, and all night he continued in prayer to God. And when day came, he called his disciples and chose from them 12 whom he named apostles: Simon, whom he named Peter, and Andrew his brother, and James and John, and Philip and Bartholomew, and Matthew and Thomas, and James the son of Alphaeus, and Simon who was called a Zealot, and Judas the son of James, and Judas Iscariot, who became a great traitor. And he came down with them and stood on a level place with a great crowd of his disciples and a great multitude of people from all Judea and Jerusalem and the sea coasts of Tyre and Sidon, who came to hear him and to be healed of their diseases. And those who were troubled with unclean spirits were cured. And all the crowd sought to touch him, for power came out from him and healed them all. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear sisters and brothers, the Gospel that I read underlines three important details of Jesus, what he did today. He prayed, he called, and he sent the disciples on mission. God calls each one of us according to his desire, not according to our merits, not according to our talents. It is he who takes the initiative to call, and he equips us with all our needs. He blesses us with his graces, and we have to respond. The human has to respond when God calls. Today, Jesus calls from the disciples 12 apostles, and before doing this important, in fact, this was one of the central things in the life of Jesus. He prayed all night to choose from the multitude 12 apostles. He prayed all night because this was something that would change the face of the world. These were ordinary people with different backgrounds, different professions, different feelings, and yet this band of apostles would set the world on fire. Jesus also called them. It is not that the disciples chose to follow Jesus, but it's Jesus who called them. Just like God who called Israel, in the same way Jesus calls 12 disciples, 12 apostles. And the mission is to do what he did, to continue what Jesus did. And everything is mentioned in the Gospel: to heal the brokenhearted, to touch, to be compassionate, to be forgiving, to be merciful. My dear sisters and brothers, like the apostles today who were chosen, we too are called. We too are chosen. We too have a mission. Jesus has prayed for us before he called us. Jesus has called us for a specific mission. The thing is that unless we are grounded, rooted in the biblical and apostolic traditions, and unless we consciously remind ourselves that I have a calling and I have to follow the will of God, and unless, like Jesus who prayed for us, unless I pray, not the normal prayers, unless I pray sitting by the side of Jesus, listening to him and talking to him, I will not know what his plan is for me, what his mission is for me. Today, on this festive day, to the intercession of these two apostles and all the other apostles, let us commit ourselves. Spend some time before Jesus, listening to what his plans are for me. Let us begin it in our own personal world, in our own families, in our own communities, and then the world, like the apostles, will be set on fire. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer you, fruit of the earth, work of human hands, which will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer you. Fruit of divine work of human hands, it will become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear sisters and brothers, that this my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our loving Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
As we venerate the perpetual glory of the holy apostles Simon and Jude, O Lord, we ask that you receive our prayers and lead us to worthy celebration of the sacred mysteries through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you, Eternal Shepherd, do not desert your flock, but through the blessed apostles, watch over it and protect it always, so that it may be governed by those who have appointed shepherd to lead it in the name of your Son. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy the four these gifts, we pray, by sending down your spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again, until you come again, until you come again, come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Oswald our Bishop, the auxiliaries and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. And all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her chaste spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, especially Saint Jude and Simon, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor to you forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, he said to the apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit."
We offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are we who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Spiritual Communion Prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Most Holy Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. Having received this sacrament, O Lord, we humbly implore you in the Holy Spirit that what we do to honor the glorious passion of the apostles Simon and Jude may keep us ever in your love through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Prayer in times of coronavirus. Mother of perpetual help, with the greatest confidence, we come before your picture to beseech your intercession. We think of you, Mother, at the foot of the cross. Your heart must have bled to see your Son in agony, but your joy was great when he rose from the dead, victorious over the powers of evil. Mother of sorrows, pray for us in this time of trial. Help us not to lose heart. Intercede for your people who are afflicted with coronavirus. Comfort your people who are vulnerable and anxious. Protect healthcare workers who put their lives at risk. Inspire our leaders to make good decisions. Change our hearts so that we may act responsibly. Teach us to trust in God's love and mercy, and to share with you the joy of having courageously faced up to all the challenges of life. Amen. Mother of perpetual help,
pray for us. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God. Final hymn, God's Spirit is in my heart. God's Spirit is in my heart. He has called me and set me apart. This is what I have to do. What I have to do. He sent me to give the good news to the poor. Tell prisoners that they are prisoners no more. Tell blind people that they can't see. And set the downtrodden free. And go tell everyone that is that the kingdom of God has come. And go tell everyone that is that God's kingdom has come.